And we're back with another episode of King's Quest, Chapter 1, A Night to Remember. I'm the RPG Chick. Okay, I believe I've ironed out the problems with stuttering last episode. I thought my SSD drive was full. Well, it was full. So I ended up playing the game on the same drive that I was writing the videos to. So that might work with some games, like some retro games, but not this one. So that was probably causing the stuttering. I managed to clean up a bunch of temporary files on my SSD drive, and believe it or not, uninstalled the game and reinstalled it on the SSD drive. Tried to get the save files over, but I guess I didn't choose the correct files or something like that, or it didn't recognize them. So I had to play this part over again. Well, I had to play previous episode over again. So I've got a bunch of, bloopers, deaths, and such that I'll put at the end of this video. Just in case you're curious, I wanted to see what they would say. It was pretty funny, some of the stuff they said and some things that happened. Anyway, we're going to continue. By the way, Gwendolyn is the name of King Graham's daughter in the original game. I did recognize the name last episode. In this, he's his granddaughter, so I'm not sure who his kids are. Maybe Gwendolyn is named after her mother. I could not say. Who goes there?
Roar! Well, hello, cousin.
Gar!
I'm glad you're finally here. He's been asking about you for days. I had to sit through the same story 5 times.
We got here as fast as we could. And I like Grandpa's stories, especially the ones with dragons.
Ah, yes, the legendary beast that he set free. I don't know if he forgets I've heard that story before or he doesn't care, but he loves telling it to anyone that will listen. I'm pretty sure I heard the nursemaids telling his same jokes in the hall.
Have you heard anything the doctors are saying?
Yes, doctors, wizards, magic elves. Grandfather is fine, Gwendolyn. They all say the same thing. He's just old. He still has a few good years left. Look, we're all excited that your family made the trip, but there's no need to worry. You should get some rest. I'm sure you're scheduled for a full morning of Grandfather's hilarious ramblings.
Hmm. Oh, I'm also scheduled for the tournament tomorrow.
Ah, yes, the fencing tournament. You'll love it. I'm, of course, favored to win, and will make sure you have the very best seat to view my victory. The courtyard will be filled with important people and delicious hors d'oeuvres.
I'm actually competing in the tournament.
Well, full of himself, isn't he?
I had no idea we were hosting a junior tournament. That's incredible. In that case,
junior?
I will gladly be there to cheer you on and eat delectable appetizers.
Nope. No junior tournament. I'll be squaring off against you.
I see. Well, perhaps this is the time to stop listening to stories and finally make some of your own. Good night, Gwendolyn. Sleep well.
Come in, Gwendolyn. You can set those on the nightstand.
I think stuttering again. And it didn't happen in my practice run.
3 spoonfuls of each.
I'll get 2 of those. No need to fuss over me. Now, let's talk about far more important issues. Like that fencing tournament. I hear you're competing.
Well, I signed up, but I'm not so sure anymore.
Nonsense. If it's Scott you're worried about, he's no bother. After all, I only learned that you entered after he complained about it all morning. Threatened, I'm guessing.
Nah.
There are many ways to win a duel. I, for one, have always been fond of...
a deft maneuver.
Precision through practice, and a deft maneuver or two. Train harder and follow your instincts. Speaking of, that reminds me of a story. One I know you haven't heard before. Well, I was a much younger lad before I was a knight, before I'd been to Daventry, and even before I'd seen a dragon. It's a tale about a tournament that changed my life. It is a long story, but I shall tell it briefly.
I'm sure you will. Help wanted.
Well, Triumph, this looks as good a place as any to camp for the night.
Triumph?
Let's rest up. We have a big day tomorrow.
What? What manner of beast is this? A giant bunny? Oh my god. Can I alter his movement? No. I did not do that.
After gracefully rappelling down the cliff, I welcome the sight of an actual road, the first sign of civilization. Daventry was just a few miles to the east. I'd read all about its wonders in my travel books. I couldn't wait to check out its famous fantastical floating island.
Floating island. I don't remember that. Because we can't see the sign. Is this east? Or is that east? It's probably the other way. I just feel like going this way to see what's up here, if anything.
Grandpa, we can't leave Triumph.
Don't worry, Triumph.
He's leaving me.
Can fend for himself. We've been through our share of sticky situations, but he always comes around when I need him most.
Yeah.
After all that graceful rappelling, I was certainly not headed back that way.
Okay, I get the hint, game. I don't suppose we have anything in inventory. Ooh. The only money to my name. 5 gold, I suppose. Vast is lost. Prancing knights. Sheesh. Ooh. He looks evil. He looks heavy. And short. He looks little.
Hey! Over here!
I could have sworn the parade of hopeful knights was scheduled for the next day. I should have been with them, marching with Triumph. It seemed my first few minutes at Daventry were off to a terrible start.
So, how did you catch up with them?
I blew this horn.
That odd horn seemed to be missing some sort of mouthpiece.
Where could this mouthpiece be? There's one more! I saw that. Well, we gotta find this mouthpiece then. I suppose that's the only thing I can look at.
Strange tracks blazed a trail through the forest.
And strange things flew around in the forest. If there's anything to look at, I'm missing it. I'm passing it by. Hopefully not. Whoop. What's that? Is that a mouthpiece? Probably. Let's go this way, though. Come here, bunnies.
I wondered what those birds needed a toolbox for.
Whoop! Went back down there, didn't it? I can't even look at the toolbox. Oh, I can.
Shame. The only tool left seemed to be a small hatchet. And no, Gwendolyn, before you start asking me thousands of questions about that hatchet, I did not go around using it on everything.
That means use it on everything. A small hatchet for using responsibly.
There was no reason to chop down a perfectly good tree.
Can't go that way. Can't go that way. Okay, headed back to those stones. How do I jump to the next one? Ah, I have to go with that. Oh, I guess I can't jump anywhere from there. I want to turn around. Okay. Oh, not that wheel again. Oh.
That wheel seemed freshly broken. That wheel seemed freshly broken.
I can't do anything with that. Let's try the hatchet.
The wheel was already broken. No sense rubbing it in.
I was gonna, you know, impale it in. Where am I going to find this mouthpiece? I have to run all the way back to find the freaking mouthpiece? After I find the mouthpiece? Hello. Greetings!
Stand back, you dirty thieves!
Whoa! Ow!
It's just a boy. Don't know where he's from, but it must be hard to pronounce. You know, you should never sneak up on a guy in a dangerous place like... No! What's wrong with your foot? Probably stepped on a spiniferous thornweed.
Don't worry, I got just the fix for that. Tell me, is it more of a ow or a oh, oh? Either way, the Merchant of Miracles has got you covered. But it'll cost you. I've risked my neck to forge the most rare, miraculous, mysterious, and oftentimes delicious ingredients. Here it is. I massage this into my skin twice a day, and just look at my little biscuits. Well, now that I've mulled it over, you'd better not. It might stunt your growth. Ooh, such exquisite material.
Hey.
Stunt your growth?
I knew you weren't from around here. Well, you best get going. Nobody likes a late night. Oh, wait. You're
get
stuck
it.
Here with me. Every virgin is out, and my shortcut had a few shortcomings. I swear that rock leaped straight out of the water. Now I'm stuck here with no wheel, a lost toolbox, and Mr. Fancy Cakes. Say, what? I'll bet a fine strapping young man like you could help me fix up this wheel. Yep, you help me fix my chariot, and I'll give you a lift to the tournament. Hopefully no one else notices your horrible lack of punctuality. Oh, how rude. Do you have any questions for me?
Oh, we got some miniature Liberace going on over here. Do we want to ask him to repeat that? Sure.
Could you repeat that?
Try to keep up, son. Bridges out, failed shortcut, flying rock, wheel broke, be a strapping lad, get tools, fix wagon, get a lift to the tournament!
Flying rock.
Find me a wheel, boy. Anything big and round should do the trick.
Right, so we gotta fix that one wheel. And what about these things?
Oh, can I pet your goats?
Stay away from my majestic unicorns!
Ha! Unicorns?
You still haven't found that replacement wheel? Hey, I'm not the one that's late for that tournament, you know. The faster you find me something big and round, the faster I can get back to my deliveries.
I don't want to see how many lines he has.
Find me a wheel, boy. Anything big and round should do the trick.
Perhaps there was a wheel on the other side of that river. Too bad I couldn't swim.
How did you get across that river?
I chopped down the tree. It's gonna fall the other way. Oh no, it worked.
That missing wheel had me stumped. I had to go out on a limb to get past the root of the problem.
But I'm bummed.
Grandpa, your infamous puns are not my favorite.
What's the matter? You don't like the timbre of my voice? You'll warm up to the puns.
These are terrible.
To the dark forest. Ooh. Eyes of doom. Hello, Eyes of Doom. You growl at me?
Here, kitty, kitty. Not a kitty, not a kitty!
Later, kitty. What? That nothing? Oh. Same thing.
No wheels are there.
Yeah, wheels don't normally growl and bite. Because there is a wheel down by the lake.
An overgrown patch of spiniferous thorn weeds obstructed a path to the water.
Well, with the ginormous dragon in it?
Perhaps.
Ginormous.
An overgrown patch of spiniferous thorn weeds obstructed a path to the water well.
The well with the ginormous dragon in it?
Perhaps.
Perhaps. Alright, let's not hit that again. Oh, do I still have the hatchet? Okay, guess I can't use that thing. Wait, let me just get closer. Hey, here we go.
I tried to chop down those thorn weeds, but my tiny hatchet was ineffective. I would need a bigger, sharper blade.
Can't look at that bush. Greetings. I come in peace. And I go in pieces. Nah.
And then you chopped down that door, found a wheel, and headed for the tournament.
No, Gwendolyn. Just because I had a hatchet didn't mean I went around using it on everything. It's not that type of story.
Use it on all the things. All them. Oh, I gotta keep hitting. Okay. What? Now what? Whoops. Didn't mean to do that. It appears that I am at an impasse. Oh, okay, duh. I learned that at the river.
Square was eerily quiet. Was I the only person in Daventry not at the parade?
Are we supposed to help that guy? We're here anyway. Should I go back and get his wheel? Let's see if I can go back and get a wheel.
Do I really have to hear the story about how you took forever to tiptoe across that fallen tree again?
Oh, I guess not.
That's funny. What if you say anything more to him?
Find me a wheel, boy. Anything big and round should do the trick.
Alright, let's go get that wheel back there.
The wheel was very broken. I would have to find another solution.
So I really can't do anything with this? Pick it up or anything?
The wheel was already broken. No sense rubbing it in.
Alright, let's head back to Daventry then.
Ooh, I'm a rock! No, I'm not! Enjoy your broken wheel!
That guy's crazy.
I returned to the empty town. This was the best place to try finding a big round wheel for the merchant.
Right, okay. Wish I had known that before. Oh, I wanted to interact with that wagon. Whatever. Can you look at anything here? What? Out here. Yeah, let's look at the door. Or open the door. Hello.
A bakery. And it smelled delicious. That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins.
I have coins.
I liked this shop, so I gave them a tip. Just because.
Yeah, that was nice of me.
The delectable goods look tasty, but I couldn't compete in this tournament with a full stomach.
But maybe you can get the cat to come out if some of it was good for the cat. The cat would want.
I didn't see any reason why that stale bread wouldn't work for a wheel.
Stale bread for a wheel. And that cape, man, gotta tell you. Huh. Still interacting with that. Okay, so we don't really have precision controls here. Alright, I guess that's it for that.
The delectable goods look tasty, but I couldn't compete in this tournament with a full stomach.
Alright. I guess we're done in here. Tiny tree.
Looked like a blacksmith shop of sorts.
Place completely empty.
That sign was asking for tips, and there was a metal pan to collect coins.
Yeah, we're gonna tip everybody. We only have two left.
I saved my money for a better opportunity.
Alright. The game won't let us mess ourselves up. That's good to know. At least not this time.
I borrowed enough for the day.
Can I look at any of this other stuff?
And then you scooped up all the weapons, right?
Right.
Right?
Yeah.
No, Gwendolyn, I didn't. Crap. I was looking for a wheel, not a fight.
But we were gonna joust. Right? That's a fight. Can we look at any of this stuff? No. Alright. What else is there to see in good old Daventry? Before I continue on this way. Go upstairs. Whee!
I stumbled upon some kind of curiosity shop.
Should we tip
against
here?
Against the knickknacks was a little collection tray with a sign asking for tips.
It's all the rage here in Daventry. Tip bowls.
I saved my money for a better opportunity.
Okay, good to know.
Nothing seemed to be brewing yet. I thought these potions, herbs, and other magical sundries were best observed from afar.
Why is that?
I didn't need to borrow more than one wheel.
That's better than a stale bread, though.
I didn't need to borrow more than one wheel.
Alright, so it's just... never mind.
I could barely make out the names of these potions. While I was up for adventure, I didn't think randomly drinking potions was a good plan.
Okay, done in there. Oh! Hello?
Hello, could I squeeze by you gents?
No. We are here to guard the town entrance and keep out any riffraff whilst everyone is watching the parade. If we were to leave, rapscallions would run amok in the empty shops.
Back rapscallions? Away, boy. We are on the lookout for intruders.
And rapscallions. Okay, I guess we're not going this way. Let's head back, I guess, with the wheel.
Like me, this little tree was new in town and needed some time to grow and find its way.
It's coming.
What? Too sappy?
I have nothing to say.
You You'll warm up to it.
Ditto. No warming up.
Ah, a shortcut.
I did not expect that. A shortcut. Oh, is it, we just go this way? It's a little bit of a shortcut. Time to say hi to this crazy guy again.
Then I use my cleverness to hide. And that's how I knew the dragon appreciated my good taste.
Grandpa, another pun?
Well, we are just getting started. After I was impaled by that spiky bed, I took a nap and decided the magic mirror could wait another evening before being rescued.
Grandpa!
Well, I thought maybe it was your bedtime, but I can continue.
Wait a minute. Does this mean our family's immortal?
Dragon Petite Four. Can you put my mouthwash back on the shelf, please? Now, where was I? I guess you could say that river swept me off my feet.
Let me guess, you escaped with only a flesh wound.